Our skin, a first conversation about race. We all have skin. It comes in different colors. What color is your skin?
White.
We see different skin colors at the playground, at the grocery store, and on TV. What skin colors do you see?
Dumbass fucking white people marking up the internet with their opinions like dogs pissing on fire hydrants.
Our friends have different skin tones. So do people in our families. What about in your family?
You look pretty white. Right?
Not only do I look white, Armenians are from the Caucasus. Like, yeah. we're white.
Our skin is beautiful, strong, and important just the way it is. What do you love about your skin?
White power.
We get our color from something smart inside our bodies called melanin that protects our skin from the sun. You have melanin too. We all do. Everybody has just the right amount for them. The darker your skin, the more melanin you have. The lighter your skin, the less melanin you have. Melanin makes our skin many beautiful shades from dark to light. What do you call your unique skin color?
White and having a penis.
Beat it, Whitey.
We may use color words to describe people, like black and white. Sometimes we say people of color to talk about all the groups of people who aren't white.
Oh, so you said that it was a white guy. What happened?
Our world has so many different groups of people, so there are lots of words we use. Black, Asian, African, Latinx, Indigenous, white.
Beat it, Whitey.
Arab, Pacific Islander, American, racial, and so many more. Skin color can't tell you much about what people are like, what they know, what foods they think are yummy, what their favorite books are, or even where they were born. Just by looking at someone, you can't tell who they are on the inside. But sometimes people try to anyway.
All Puerto Ricans carry knives, and that all Mexicans are illegal immigrants, and that all black people are violent, that every black girl is Shakisha.
A long time ago, way before you were born, a group of white people made up an idea called race. They sorted people by skin color and said that white people were better, smarter, prettier, and that they deserve more than everybody else.
Fuck whites, am I right? You are right. You ain't never been righter.
That isn't true or fair at all. But it's a story that has been told for a long time.
Christ is coming back to kick your cracker asses.
When people believe this untrue story about race, that's called racism. Racism is also the things people do and the unfair rules they make about race so that white people get more power and are treated better than everybody else.
How many times can they say the same thing? White people bad! White people bad!
Racism happens in lots of big and small ways. It's all around us, even if we don't always notice it. Racism can be a rule, like if someone says only friends with white skin can play. Racism can be an idea, like thinking princesses only have blonde hair.
We gotta take those motherfuckers out.
Racism can be a way we've done things for a long time, like how there aren't as many books written about people of color. Racism can be on purpose, like calling a person of color a mean name because of their skin color.
You niggers are why I lost my job.
Racism can be by mistake, like if the same friend always has to play the bad guy.
Fuck that.
Racism hurts and is always unfair.
Black people across this country are exhausted.
That's why it's important to talk about it and do our part to make things better. All the time, even right now, people are working for racial justice by telling the truth and sharing feelings, by treating people the way they want to be treated. By bravely saying, "That's not right." By marching in protest, by singing songs that bring us together.
I'm 100% nigger.
By changing unfair rules, by teaching, helping, learning, and listening. We can do it too.
Hours out of Mackinac City, stopped in a bar to have a brew. Met a girl and we had a few drinks and I told